Hey there, my name is Alberto and today I will teach you to code a CMS neural network. This is a deep learning architecture widely used in applications that rely on machine. For example, detect minute changes in documents, matching response to jobs, tracking for video surveillance, audio recognition, etc. It contains two identical networks. Identical means that they have the same configuration with the same parameters and the same weights. And it returns a couple of feature vectors that are used to find the similarity of the inputs. Well, this video will consist in four parts: dataset, model, loss function, and inference. Let's begin.
As dataset, we must have pair of images with a label. The label will be 1 if the images are from the same class, and 0 if they don't. So there is a very simple way to create this. I am using the dataset class from PyTorch, and I need to fill 3 methods. I have init, get item, and len. So in the constructor, I am using 2 parameters, data and transforms. Transforms are the modifications that I want to do to the images. And data is a list. It's a list that contains image paths and its IDs. So it have the next structure. Data is equal to a list of elements that contains image path and image ID. This is what I am passing to the dataset class. In the getIrem function is where I will create the pair of images. So I randomly select a number, 0 or 1. If it is 1, then I will create a pair of images from the same class. Otherwise, I will create a pair of images from different classes. So this is just a loop that goes until it reach a pair of the same class, and another loop to find a different image from a different class. After that, I just read the image, I convert the label to a tensor, and I apply transforms if I send transforms in the constructor. So that's all in the getIrem function. And in the length, I just return the length of the list that I have, and that is everything for the dataset. The model is very simple and confusing the first time. If you search images from CMS networks, you will see a diagram showing 2 different networks. And I said before that it consists of 2 identical networks. But I am just defining one. Why? Well, since they are identical, they have the same configuration, same parameters, same weights, I don't have the necessity to declare another network. I just need to declare one and pass each image through it. So that's what I did. In this case, I replicated the architecture used in the paper called CMS neural networks for one-shot learning. It consists of 4 convolutional blocks and 2 dense layers. It returns only 1 feature vector for each image. And the important part is here in the forward. In the forward, we need to extract the feature vectors for each image. So we send each image to the forward once method. It passes the image through the serial convolutional layers, then threaten it and pass it through the dense layers and returns only 1 feature vector. So that's what we have here. And that is everything about the definition of the model. The loss function is the key part of the CMS network. In this case, we have a constructive loss. It takes as input the feature vectors that we got from the model together with the label. It calculates the gradient distance, which will tell you how different are these 2 feature vectors. And this is very important because this is the part where you join the 2 networks and then you use the gradient distance to calculate the loss. The loss will be dimensioned on each training step. This is basically all and the most important part of the CMS network. To do inference, we pass the pair of images through the network and then we calculate the gradient distance again. Recall that the gradient distance will tell you how dissimilar are those images. So in this case, I am changing the similarity for similarity and I am using a threshold. So let's say that the gradient distance returns a 0.7 and my threshold is 0.8 and I have a very aggressive threshold of 0.8, then I will say that the images are different. But if I have a low threshold of 0.5 and the gradient distance returns 0.7, I will say that the images are from the same class. So basically this is my function from inference. And this is the last of the 4 key components that you need to know in order to build your own CMS model. And if you want to go deeper and make something like this, well, I will leave you the link below in the description so you can check it later.
And now you know how to build a CMS model. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more.